I call the work contemporary embroidery, but I'm not trained as an embroiderer. I've never learned, you know, formally taken any training in embroidery. It's more just stitching. And really my first love is drawing, and I consider these pieces really just drawings with thread. They're always inspired by nature. The root forms, the feeling of water flowing, and growing up here in the woods, that's how I spent my childhood, playing in the woods, playing by the water. And it's always been, you know, the inspiration using those forms as metaphor in my work. I always come back to some sort of process-oriented art, making something with my hands. I love that process of touching the fabric, making a thing. So I've been thinking more about the work as soft sculpture rather than a flat piece. So we really chose the elements of the boxes to, you know, enhance the forms that were in the pieces already.
Erin's work functions on a lot of different levels. For me, and I think for our viewers, it's definitely, while it's really meticulously made and there's a serious attention to craft and detail, the concept is really strong and also sort of broad enough where a lot of people can identify with it, regardless of what your background is or, you know, if you know about art or not. There is that sort of healing, sort of spiritual side. That's really important to the work.
And on this piece I have some antique lace that was actually my great-grandmother's, and I sewed that on first because I wanted to make an area within the stain where I was going to work. So this is where I'm just laying in the basic beginning of the red areas, and around the edges here I'm using a red thread that I over-dyed with the walnut ink, the same red but with the brown over top, to add a little bit of shading to give some depth to the forms around the edges. The other aspect of my work is that it's really about women, specifically the women in my family. You know, it's something that's always drawn women together, whether it be a quilting bee or women stitching around the fire at night, around candlelight. It's just a very intimate medium. You know, many women in my family, my great-grandmother was a hat trimmer. My other great-grandmother made costumes for the mummers. I mean, it's always been, you know, a family of people making things. So it's definitely something that I grew up around, because obviously the stitching is very controlled. I can do exactly what I want.
On an aesthetic level, it's really beautiful, but it also has an element of the grotesque, where at first, you know, you're seeing these sort of innocent, like newborn dresses, but then there's this kind of blood splatter. Then when you get closer to it, you realize that it's this really amazingly stitched element that's like, this is the art of it. So I think there's a nice contrast between those two things. And with Erin's work, there's a lot of different conclusions that you could come to when you're looking at it.
Mm-hmm.